General Motors' troubles have crashed into NASCAR, with GM meeting today to discuss spending cutbacks for NASCAR. Bob Dorfman, executive creative director at Baker Street Advertising, says many corporate sponsors are being cautious right now with spending. Mr. Dorfman joins us live from San Francisco. Sir, welcome to Bloomberg News.
Thank you.
Cautious with spending, just how cautious?
Well, very cautious. I mean, we're talking about, in terms of NASCAR, we're talking about the big three car companies spending last year $500 million in sponsorships. And that's going to be cut drastically. I mean, they've already cut. Ford's cut 10 to 20%. Toyota's cut even. Everybody's retrenching. Everybody's, kind of reexamining their sponsorships, particularly in sports, and looking very cautiously at where they're putting their money.
Man, a lot of car companies supply the cars, and they support the teams, do they not?
Yes, they do. And, NASCAR certainly is considered one of the strongest sponsorship opportunities in sports because it's a very loyal audience. And for the car companies, it also offers a lot of research and development opportunities. But still, a GM that's bankrupt has to look very closely at the ramifications of spending, eight figures, even nine figures in NASCAR at this point. They have bigger fish to fry and much more important things to deal with, I think.
Any of the teams, as far as you know, who's been suffering the most because of this corporate decline, this decline in sponsorship?
I think Richard Petty had to merge with other companies. I think they've had to lay off some people. That's the name that comes to the forefront more than any at this point, I think.
You say Honda is one of your clients. It's pulling their money out of Formula One. Give us a sense on how that's affecting that climate as well.
Well, in terms of Formula One, again, it's all the car companies are just being very, very careful about where their money is going. I know Honda has put some money into the NHL. They've become the main sponsor of the Hockey League. And demographically, they say that that's a much better match for them at this point in time. And it's probably a smaller investment for them as well.
Now, GM ended support for teams in two lower-level NASCAR series on Friday, so it's not just the top tier. The lower tiers are suffering as well.
Absolutely, and it's across all sports for GM, too. They didn't advertise in the Super Bowl. They pulled Cadillac from their Masters sponsorship. They dropped Tiger Woods as a Buick sponsor, endorser, and, arguably the strongest and most compelling endorser in all of sports, and they had to let him go.
You think that Ford and Toyota and other car dealers are going to follow suit?
I think so, definitely. Toyota, I think, has gotten into NASCAR only in the past 3 to 5 years. It's been very successful for them. They may be the biggest sponsor, when all this kind of clears out. They may end up being the biggest sponsor of all car companies. And I think you'll be seeing NASCAR looking to more foreign car companies to get them more involved because obviously they're more healthy economically.
And is that where some of the specific teams in NASCAR are looking as well, maybe looking overseas because things are drying up that much here in the U.S.?
Yeah, I think they're looking overseas, looking at foreign car companies that have strong presences in the United States, the Hondas, the Mercedes, BMW, Hyundai, and I think they're also looking to their non-automotive clients and sponsors and hoping to get them to fill in the gaps.
I guess at this point, if you're a fan of NASCAR, I guess it really does, it hits close to home now because you do realize how much corporate sponsorship is, for lack of a better phrase, the engine that drives that sport.
That's true. And again, you're seeing attendance down at a lot of races. You're seeing TV viewership down. So, it's affecting the consumer, too. The average NASCAR fan, makes about $50,000 a year or less. So they're hurting their pocketbooks, too. So, you may see fewer races, as an upshot of this. You may see shorter races.
Right.
The weekends may get, consolidated fewer events. So it's going to affect the average consumer who's a big NASCAR fan as well.
Mr. Dorfman, about 20 seconds left. Are we going to see a turn here? Do you see maybe in the next couple of years where this might reverse itself?
I think so. I don't know that it's ever going to come back to where it was, but I think it's going to turn around. I think NASCAR has to be hoping that Danica Patrick will join their team when her IRL contract ends up.
Bob Dorfman of Baker Street Advertising joining us from San Francisco talking about NASCAR. Mr. Dorfman, thanks.